This video highlights the 2022 Data Submission Manual Attestation for the MIPS Promoting Interoperability Performance category. We'll walk through how to attest or manually enter data for the Promoting Interoperability category on the QPP website. Promoting interoperability data is reported at the individual or group level, even if the quality data is reported at the APM entity level, such as the Shared Savings Program ACOs reporting in the APP. When reporting, we recommend that you only use one submission method, either manually attest or upload a file. Any conflicting data between two submissions will result in a score of 0 for this category. After signing into the QPP website, click Eligibility and Reporting on the homepage. Here, you can see all practices your account is associated with. Choose the practice and select the appropriate reporting button based on whether your practice is reporting as a group or individuals. In this video, we'll choose group reporting, but the process is the same whether reporting as a group or individual. Click Report as Group. Clinicians and groups that have certain special statuses, such as non-patient facing or an approved hardship exception application, are exempt from reporting the Promoting Interoperability category. This is indicated by NA. We can see there is an NA for Promoting Interoperability in the scoring section, as well as NA on the Promoting Interoperability card below. Clinicians and groups who are exempt have the option of still reporting for the category. Within the card, select Create Manual Entry. If the Promoting Interoperability category is reweighted, you'll be presented with a prompt reminding you of your current weights. If you still want to proceed with reporting this performance category, select Yes, I agree, and Continue. If you click Continue and enter any data, including performance period dates, you will receive a score in this performance category. Otherwise, you can cancel out of the prompt. For purposes of this video, this group has data to report, so we'll continue with creating a manual entry. Click Create Manual Entry. From here, the system will take you step by step through data required. We start with a performance period. When entering the dates, please remember, you must report at least 90 days of data for the category. Anything less than 90 days will prompt a notification, reminding you of the requirement and the resulting score of 0 for this category. When 90 days or more are entered, you will move on to the next step, CERT, or Certified EHR Technology ID. For detailed instructions on how to generate a CMS EHR certification ID, review pages 26 to 29 of the Certified Health IT Product List, or CHPL, Public User Guide. After the CERT ID is entered, the system will allow you to complete your responses to the attestation statements. The first three attestation statements are required. Failure to answer will result in a score of 0 for the category. From here, work your way through the required measures. New for 2022 is the High Priority Practice Guide of the Safety Assurance Factors for EHR Safer Guides measure. During the submission period, you will attest to the Safer Guide attestation measure by entering a yes or no response. Both yes and no satisfy reporting requirements for this measure. Failure to report either yes or no for the High Priority Practices Safer Guides measure will result in no score for the Promoting Interoperability Performance category. Also, beginning in 2022, there are now two required measures for the Public Health and Clinical Data Exchange measure, Electronic Case Reporting and Immunization Registry Reporting. To earn an additional 5 bonus points in this performance category, you can choose to report one or more of the remaining optional measures. There are 5 bonus points available whether you report 1, 2, or 3 of all the optional measures. After all required data have been entered, you will receive a prompt informing you that all Promoting Interoperability objectives have been met and you can view your preliminary score. On the left-hand navigation, select Group Reporting Overview. Now, there will be a score populated. You can review and change your responses until the submission window closes. For more information, please review these resources available on the QPP Resource Library.